Hello, a warm welcome to everyone to this massive open online course on applied optimization with applications in wireless communications, machine learning and big data. Now, the title of this course itself implies that this concept of convex optimization or this area of optimization has applications in a very broad set of areas or in a very vast set of areas. I mean, it has a diverse set of applications. Now, what does optimization mean? Optimization essentially at the core of it in a very abstract sense is that given a cost function or given some kind of an objective function that has to be maximized, you find an optimal point or you find the optimal value of a certain variable that gives you the optimal value of the objective function. Correct? That at the core of it, that is basically an optimization problem. You are trying to minimize a cost function. Now, in particular, a convex optimization problem, which can be solved rather efficiently, is a problem where you are trying to find this optimal value of a convex objective function that arises very frequently and also has several applications. For instance, if you look at a wireless communications, I am going to introduce several very simple applications. For instance, you can consider a cooperative wireless scenario in which, now traditionally we have a scenario in which a single base station is transmitting to a single user. Now, if you generalize it, you can have several base stations that cooperate to transmit to several users. Now, in such a cooperative wireless communication scenario, there are several things to be optimized. For instance, what are the optimal power levels at which the base stations can be transmit, all right? Or what are the desired signal to noise power ratios of the various users? So this can be posed as an optimization problem, all right? So there are several contexts. Now, another important aspect application of this optimization framework is to determine the channels, the communication, that is the wireless channel between the base station and each user. Alright. Now, another very important application which arises in various wireless communication scenarios, especially when you have multiple antenna arrays, is that of beamforming. These antenna arrays can be used to focus or transmit the signal by focusing the energy in a particular direction towards the desired user, thereby minimizing the energy spread in all other directions, that increases the energy efficiency. Now, optimization can help you calculate the optimal beamformers or optimal beamforming weights that can be applied at the base station, so that you focus the maximum amount of energy in the direction of the desired user while minimizing or if possible setting equal to 0 the energy that is radiated in the other directions. That improves the energy efficiency of wireless communications and it is very important in most of the modern wireless communication standards. Alright. So, optimization has a role to play there. Now, signal processing is another very large area where optimization has several applications. For instance, most of you must have heard of the paradigm of compressive sensing. Now, traditionally you sense, for instance, you capture an image and compress it into a format such as JPEG format and so on. Now, compressive sensing is a radical new paradigm in which you sense or you, in which you compress before sensing or you compress while sensing. What that does is that significantly reduces the number of sensors that are required for the traditional sensing process. So, thereby reduces the cost and makes the system more efficient. So, the optimization, and this is known as estimation or this is known as the capture of a sparse signal. So, optimization has a very important role to play in compressive sensing and for that matter, this is just an example, it has an important role to play in several areas of signal processing. Other new areas, for instance, machine learning, we are trying to classify two different sets of objects as indicated, so two different data sets. They can correspond to various different things. For instance, these two data sets can correspond to different pictures of various objects. So, you can classify these into various sets. So, machine learning, as computers are becoming more powerful, machine learning has machine learning for autonomous applications, for instance, applications such as autonomous driving, UAVs, etcetera, to classify objects in unmanned aerial vehicles. These kind of applications are gaining a lot of prominence and big data with the increase in the size of the data sets, with the amount of with increase in the mobile devices, with increase in the computers, the storage capacity, as well as the rate at which data is generated using multiple, for instance, in social networks and multiple media, is increase has increased several fold, has increased exponentially. All right. So there are several applications related to processing and extracting trends from such big data. For instance, I can talk about a simple example where this problem of matrix completion, where there are several users. Who have given ratings for several movies that they have seen, all right. But there are several movies that the various users have also not seen. So based on the ratings for the movies that the different users have given, can you complete or can you deduce the ratings for the movies that they have not seen, thereby prioritizing or suggesting a set of preferred movies for each user? This can be formulated as a matrix completion problem, and that has also can be solved using the framework of optimization that's going to be developed in this course. So as you can see, optimization, in fact, or in particular convex optimization, which we are going to focus on during this course, has several applications in a variety of domains, be it wireless or signal processing, big data. These are only a few domains. It can have, there are many other domains, all right, in which it has several interesting and very novel applications. In fact, several of these techniques have developed only recently in the past 5 to 10 years, and as a result of this, these techniques are very much a very active area of current research, all right. And as I have said, since this course itself, optimization, arises in various fields of engineering and science, it would be of interest to students in several branches such as electrical engineering, electronics and communication engineering, mathematics, economics, computer science, management, several traditional, even in fact non-traditional areas of both engineering and so a vast set of students will be able to derive material or relevant material from this course. The prerequisites are also very minimal. It's a basic, I'm going to assume only a basic knowledge of calculus, probability, matrices and linear algebra, and basically comfort with mathematics, the various mathematical constructs such as calculus, differentiation, integration, these are some of the basic prerequisites that are going to be essential to understand the concepts that will be covered in this course, all right. So all in all, it's a very exciting course because of the relatively new nature of the material that has been developed in the very recent past, combined with the vast or the wide variety of domains in which optimization or these various paradigms of optimization can be applied, makes it indeed very interesting. I look forward to covering the various modules of this course, and I look forward to interacting with you more, and I look forward to once again welcoming you to this course, this massive open online course. Thank you very much.